Good morning, children. Welcome back with the next new class. So today in this class we are going to discuss a fresh new topic. Okay. So our lesson will be today production in a factory, a paper mill. Production in a factory, a paper mill. Okay. So lesson is lesson 7. Production in a factory. A paper mill. Okay, this is lesson number 9. So, production in a factory, a paper mill. Okay, so by the lesson itself, you can understand that we are going to discuss about the production in a factory. That means how a production is taken place in a factory. And that too we are going to discuss especially about the paper mill. We all know, no? We have paper mill in Rajahmundry. So here paper mill, what they produce is paper, obviously. By the name itself, it is very much clear they produce paper. So during the production of the paper, there are many stages. So every day we use paper, no? Without using paper, we cannot even write or whatever we do. Every book, it is of paper only, okay? So to make this paper, there are many stages in these papers, okay? So how the paper comes from? Where does the papers come from? Okay, how papers are made, how many days it takes to make a paper. Okay, we shall all learn about this in detail in this lesson. Okay, so first production in a factory. So to produce any goods, okay, to produce any goods. Okay, so here in this lesson, I'll be using the word, instead of goods, I'll be using a word known as commodity. Commodity, okay, see, the word known as commodity. C-O-M-M-O-D-I-T-Y, commodity, C-O-M-M-O-D-I-T-Y, commodity, commodity means goods, okay. So, to produce any good or to produce any commodity, they need some raw materials. For example, if you want to decorate your class for Independence Day. Okay, your class teacher has given you a task to decorate your class for an Independence Day. First thing, what you do? First you plan, okay, you collect money, okay, after collecting and all, okay, what you do? You get the materials what are required to decorate the class. For example, ribbons, balloons, okay, any kind of like sparkle sheets and all, whatever you know better. So all those things are required, isn't it, to decorate a class. So what are the basic things what you needed here? Some ribbons, some balloons, some sparkle glitter threads and all. Okay. So all these are known as raw materials. Now, for example, your mother is making your favorite dish. Okay. Your mother is making your favorite dish. For example, you like eating Maggie. Okay. You wanted to eat Maggie. So your mother has went into the kitchen to prepare. So before preparing Maggie, so what are the things she requires? The ingredients, we say, no, in the, see, every cooking show they'll say, no, ingredients, what are the things that are needed to prepare the dish. Okay, there are ingredients in your Maggie, some, okay, first thing the Maggie you want, okay, some vegetables like carrots, capsicums, cabbage, whatever vegetables you have, some green peas and all, okay, some salt, that Maggie, whatever the masala or the flavor what they give, okay, your sauce and all you put, no, so all these things are ingredients, isn't it? So all these things are known as raw materials to prepare a Maggie. That means these are the required items to finish a product. Now here, every product needs some raw materials to make it a finished product. Okay, now, for example, You sit on wooden benches. Okay. Those wooden benches, the wood comes from the trees. The woods has to be cut. Okay. Cut it into some rectangular pieces, horizontal pieces, or whatever pieces they cut. Then they make a proper shape. Then they use some needles. Okay. To fix it. They use some glue. Some Fevicol kind of glue they use. okay, and then they finally make it as a bench. And in some benches they also use some iron rods, isn't it, to make it more strong. Okay, so these are also known as, so these are raw materials for the benches. Now for to finish every product they need some or the other raw materials. Now one more point you should understand. Now some people prepare raw materials, like for example, some prepare whatever the materials they produce are fixed products for them, but when the same product is used by the other people are known as raw materials for them. Okay, I think you got confused, let me just clear. For example, a person who makes iron ore things, okay, or steel things, okay, so there is a small factory where needles as well as screws are made, needles and screws are made. So that person produces or makes needles and screws, okay. So what is his raw material? Either iron or steel, either iron needles or steel screws. So that is his raw material to make the needles or the screw. Okay, he needs those raw materials to make them finished product. Okay, for him, for this person X, for this person X, for example, a person who is an iron, okay, who is a blacksmith, okay, who is a blacksmith, okay, he is making some needles, okay, some needles. For him, needles are finished product. For him, needles are finished products here, okay. So before making needles, what did he require? He requires some iron, okay, some metals, iron, or if he is making some steel screws or something like that, okay. So what is the material for him? What are the raw materials? Either iron or steel. What is the final product what he is making? He is making needles or screws, okay. So this is his finished product. This is his finished product. Needle or screw he has made. It is finished till here. Now, for making benches, I gave you an example of making benches. So here, now the work starts about the carpenter. Now we are going to talk about carpenter. Okay, what does a carpenter do? A carpenter work is to use wood and prepare some furnitures. Use wood and prepare some furnitures. So just in the example I told you that a carpenter who is preparing our benches, what are his raw materials? Wood, needles, glue, okay, are his raw materials. Now so he prepares a bench, okay, or table. He prepares benches or tables, okay. So what are his raw materials? Iron, screws or needles are his raw materials. That means one person finished product is raw material for another person. One person's finished product is another person's raw material. Please keep this thing in your mind. One person's finished product can be raw material for some other person. Okay, so this is what I wanted to explain and give you a clarity here. Okay, so now, so in this lesson we are going to talk about the paper mill factory. Okay, paper mill, we all know, no, APPM paper mill factory in Rajahmundry we have, isn't it? Some of your family members or may you might be your relatives who is working in the paper mill. Okay, if you get an opportunity to enter into the paper mill, definitely go there, visit their factory. Okay, how the things are made, how actually the papers are made, what quality of papers are they making. You can go there and watch the complete process there. Okay, for today in this class I'm going to tell you a process in a step by step wise. Okay, firstly this paper, we get the material of the papers, the raw material for making a paper is wood. The raw material to make a paper is wood. Now you can say, miss, wood is brown in color, paper is white in color. So how come it turns from brown to white? From turning a wood to a paper, there are many steps here. To turn the wood to the paper, it has many steps here. Okay, so firstly what they do is, they go and they cut some trees. they go and cut some trees. Now the trees what they use is the bamboo trees. The trees what usually the paper mill people use is the bamboo trees. They cut the bamboo trees, get the bamboo logs. Logs means what? The fat ones or all the big what is it? We say no pieces of like this or trunks. Okay, or sometimes bamboos are like this, isn't it? Okay, they get these bamboos from the forest. So what is happening? So day by day, every like people who are educated or non-educated, even they also use paper. Okay, for example, magazines, newspaper, notebooks, textbook, exam papers, report card, whatnot. Everything is made of papers here. Now, people use paper in many ways in their daily life. Okay, now all this paper day by day production of the paper are being increased. Now, what is happening here? To make such papers, more trees are being cut. More and more trees are being cut. So this is finally what is happening there. The problem of deforestation is coming. The problem of deforestation is raising here. Now slowly the bamboo trees are all cut down. Now government is observing that to make a paper, so many trees have been cut. So what to do? So what they have done is, instead of using bamboos, now they have shifted using bamboo. Instead of bamboo, they are using sabudal. Okay, sabudal is a tree of which they use the wood as to make a paper. Okay, sabudal is a tree here. Okay, so what happens here? So usually this kind of sabudal tree is found in the forest, in the tribe, in the villages. Usually these kind of trees are found in the villages, in the like in the forests there. So what happened? Now you might have learned in your 6th standard about early life to settled life. Okay, or gathering food to growing food lesson you have learned, no? People in the forest, they used to, this tribal people used to stay in the forest to look after the forest. They used to protect the forest, isn't it? So what happened? These government people or the people who are a factory people, they have asked the people or tribal people to collect, to cut such trees and provide them the wood of sabudal. Okay, to provide such wood to them. So what happened here? So these people started cutting. Instead of that, they have started paying them in amount. Okay, and they were also told by the government, please encourage your people to grow such trees only, to grow such trees only. So it was requested by the government to only plant more of sabudal, usually in the village forests. Okay, now this is over. Now, so here in this lesson, it's a story of a person, not story. Here a person goes to the paper mill. So he is explaining his journey towards the paper mill. So what happened? He has entered into the paper mill. He sees that when entering, if he finds there are some two or three lorries standing outside the gate of paper mill. Okay, here in Rajahmundry only. So he is standing. So he sees there are some two to three lorries waiting with the wood of some sabudal trees, wood, these trunks of some sabudal, lorry full of all this wood is been waiting outside the gate. So, and this person is also waiting for his chance to come inside. So he got permission from some people. So he wants to visit the process of making the paper. So he gets permission. So when entering, he has registered his name in the register there. So after registering, he was allowed to go inside the paper mill factory. So once he has entered, he sees there are two gates. One for the people who are working, that means the workers. There are two gates. One is for workers and other for big lorries to enter into the paper mill. So he along with the other, the trucks were also entering. So when he entered, he sees that the first stage, what happens here is people are unloading. People are unloading all the wood from the lorry, shifting them down. Okay, so once they have put them down, so what happened? After putting them down, they have started taking them into the lorries by the help of conveyor belt. You have seen, no, conveyor belt, just putting something like, for example, if you have been through airports and all, some other metropolitan cities and all, if you go there, okay, what they, in the movies you have seen, no, putting their luggage on the belts and after checking and all, the bag will again come back. They have to collect their bag. So that is known as conveyor belt. So what happened is, this wood is also put on the conveyor belts. So once the wood starts its journey into the factory, so the wood starts going into the factory. So first step, what happens is chipping. The first step what happens is chipping. So let me just write in detail. First process there, what happens is steps. First, chipping. C-H-I-P-P-I-N-G. Chipping. Okay. The name itself, you can understand a bit. Chip. Chips. Okay. Not eating chips. Okay. Yeah. Chipping means the wood will be cut into small, will be cut into like pieces. Okay. Uneven pieces. Not in a proper shape. Will be cut into pieces. Within 1 hour, they cut a lorry of trees. That means whatever the wood they have brought, no? So all these are cut in 1 hour. So what happened here is, so after cutting them, that means chopping or chipping, okay? They make the wood into small chips. They make the wood into small chips. So here small chips, what now they, the people who are working, no? The factory workers and all, they will separate small chips and big chips. Whatever pieces are left over, big pieces will be again thrown into the machine. Sorry. Again, they will be thrown into the machine to make it as a small chips. Now, all these small chips, once the small chips are all gathered, so all these small chips will be taken to the next stage. Okay, so the next stage, what happens is, they start boiling them. That means preparing the pulp. Preparing the pulp. Preparing. Preparing the pulp. So what is making of, what is meaning of pulp? So pulp is the juice. Okay, the pulp is the juice. For example, we eat no Minute Maid mango, sorry, Minute Maid oranges and all. What is the juice? It is the extracts of the real oranges. That means what the orange really have the juice in it as well as the content in it. For example, if you take a mango, okay, except the seed, the remaining thing, what comes, no, it is called pulp. Okay, in Telugu it is called gujju, we'll say, no? Okay, gujju. Okay, so whatever the this chips have, okay, this chips will be boiled in the containers, okay, in the boilers. They will be boiled there, including some chemicals added to them, including some chemicals added to them. So it starts boiling and boiling and boiling. So what happens after some time, this chip starts getting melted. This chips started getting melted. That means the hardwood turns into a soft thread like cotton. Okay, it starts melting and turns itself like a cotton threads. Okay, and the real juice, whatever has come, will be coming down at the bottom. Will be coming down at the bottom. So that white, so now the when they make the pulp, no, so the white juice will come down. So when that white kind of liquid, whatever is comes, no, it will be in a pure milk form without any dust on that. Pure milk form without any dust on that. Now, after preparing the pulp, the next stage they take is to pressing, rolling. Pressing and rolling. Okay, they press it and roll it here. Now, whatever the pulp comes here, they put in a cylindrical kind of a machine here. So, all this pulp is applied to the cylinder kind of a machine here. So all is, everything is applied. So here what happens, so the press, so what happens here, the pulp starts getting dried. The pulp starts getting dried. So once it get dried, that means whatever, due to the heat and the evaporation process starts, that means all whatever the moisture is there, no, starts getting evaporated. And whatever is the pulp is there, no, this white liquid form starts getting dry. So after drying, they'll be again putting into the machine for pressing them. Okay, for pressing them very hardly so that it should not change its shape here. Now, when it is pressing, no, actually the thickness of the paper, okay, or at to what size of the paper is decided here only. The thickness of the paper or the width of the paper is been decided here. So pressing and rolling are the process where the paper, the quantity as well as the width of the paper is decided. For example, your notebook's paper is thin, whereas see the paper quality of the chart paper, how thick the paper is. This has all been decided in the process of pressing and rolling. Okay, even drying also has happened here. Okay, now after this, finally what they do is they just pack these papers. So that they just pack these papers and they just send them to the next product, like send them to their godowns. So after packing, they send them to the godowns. So what happens after pressing and rolling? They usually give them for cutting. Okay, fourth process is cutting. So here, cutting the papers into big sheets. Okay, cutting the paper into big sheets. After cutting them, they have to fold it, they have to pack it, and they have to send it to their godowns. Now, once the godown reaches, then it will be taken to the wholesalers. Okay, people who buy in a bulk, that means in a big quantity, people who buy, they are known as wholesalers. Now, wholesalers take the papers, cut the papers, make into the notebooks. Okay, see here, the first thing I told, their paper mill finished product is paper, but people who are making books, for them, these paper is again raw material. You understood? For paper mill here, paper is finished product. That means product is finished. Their work is finished here. But people who are making the actual books, for them this paper is acting as a raw material. Okay? So these people who they will just buy the paper from this paper mill factory and all. They cut it. They give it a proper shape. Okay? 100 pages, 200 pages, 500 pages. Big notebook, small notebook, colored notebooks, or single rule, double rule, broad rule, whatever rules it is. It is all done by the people who make the books again. Okay. So, here, chipping, pressing the pulp, preparing the pulp, pressing and rolling and cutting are the steps we have to make the paper here. Now, in the paper mill factory, every stages, like all these four stages are done in different sections. Okay, there are some different places appointed for only chipping. Different section, that means different place was given for preparing the pulp. Place is also given for this pressing, drying and rolling. Okay, other place is given for cutting. Okay, so this paper mill factory has all these different sections, as well as different workers. Group of people are working for all these things. Okay, so this was the lesson, production in a factory, a paper mill. So we have learned about the raw materials, that means the importance of raw materials and different things. We have learned for one people if it is a raw material, that means for one people if it is a finished product, the other people may consider that finished product as a raw material. I have given you a clarity. I have told you about this bamboo as well as the sabudal are the two trees that are used for making papers. I have explained about the steps for making a paper. Okay, so here in Andhra Pradesh, there are two places. One is Rajahmundry, that means East Godavari, and other is Kurnool, are the two places where we find the paper mill factory. Okay, so this was the lesson. So in the further lesson, we are going to discuss about how many shifts in the people work, that means how many shifts they come and they work. Okay, next we are going to learn about preparing of paper at home. Okay, we are going to learn about preparing of paper, for how many shifts the people work. Okay, how many people work in these things? Okay, we'll all learn in the next part of the lesson. Till then, bye children. And for any more doubts and queries, please ask us immediately. We'll meet up in the next upcoming class. Till then, bye. Have a nice day.